Alright, so on a website, forms are used to gather information and requests from your user. So in this video, I'll go over how to build form for your pages. So before starting with building a form, you guys should know what a form is. So when you register for a social media or register for any site, they ask for your collective personal data. The data that you enter in and the layout that you see is created using HTML forms. So I'll just show you a small example of HTML forms. This right here, you can see I can enter my name, my email ID, my subject, my message, and I have this submit button. So when I submit this form that I filled, it will be submitted to the required personnel. Okay, now we are going to create a form using form basics. Your form may not look like this because this has been created using various other languages. Okay, but now we learn how to create form using just HTML. Okay, so right now you can see in HTML we write all of the content in our body tag. Okay, whatever we want we write inside body tag. So similarly for form elements, whatever you want inside the form is written inside the form tag. So the first thing that we need to do is open up a form tag. So it goes like this, form, then a closing form tag. So always remember, as soon as you open up a tag, you should always close it. Okay, so you don't forget it later on. Many of the time what happens is you forget to close a tag and your code won't run properly and people think that there's some huge mistake, but there's some minor mistakes are there like this one. Okay, should always close off your tag as soon as you open it. Now for form tag to work correctly, it needs two attributes. So you guys know what attributes are, right? The first attribute that is needed is called the action attribute. And what do you mention this action attribute? The action attribute tells the browser where that data is to be submitted, where this form is to be submitted and what happens to it. Okay, so if you have a server that collects the data, all of your data through all of the various forms that people have filled, and it is stored on one server, so you mention, you enter the server address inside this double quotes. But right now we don't have a server, so we'll just leave it empty. Now the second attribute is called the method attribute. And it has two values. The first is get value and the second is post value. So the get value is passive. It puts the data up to the browser, and the post value tells the browser that the data is secured. Data is to be secured. What get does is it puts the data up to the address. And what post does is it tells the browser that the data is to be secured. So if you're going to use this post value, okay, this was basic about forms. You should always create a form and you should always mention these two attributes, that is action and method. If any of this one value is also missing, your form won't work correctly. So always write this both of the attributes. Now let's say that I want a normal text box where I can input my username or where I can input my name. So how do we create that? We can do that by using input tag. Now we'll open up an input tag and we'll close it. Now input is a self-closing tag. That means we don't need any other tag. Now there are number of attributes that we have for input tag, but there are three common attributes that we're always going to use in every input tag. The first attribute is called the type attribute. And here, now we're just going to enter my name. Suppose I have to enter my name. So I'll just select text option. Okay. The second attribute that we're going to use is called the name. Now you can give name, you can give any name, I'll just call it text box. Okay, and the third attribute will be value. Let's say value, and let's just leave this empty for now. I'll tell you what it does later on. Okay, so now you can see this tag is complete and this text box has appeared. Now we can enter our name, we can enter numbers, we can enter special characters, we can enter anything that we want. Okay, there's no restriction. Now once the data has been entered, I have to submit this form. So I want a submit button. So how do I create that? So always remember that you should always create a submit button and you should always create it before closing the form, that is at the end of the form. So again, I'll add one more input tag. Then I'll add type attribute. And this time in type attribute, I'll select submit option. Okay, because I want a submit button, right? I'll give it a name. Let's call it submit button. And then I'll give, let's just leave value. So you can see submit has appeared here. Okay. And it is clickable. Now, once I enter this value, Anything that I write inside this double quotes will be displayed here. Suppose I want login instead of submit. So once I write login inside this value, this is what will happen. Okay, login will be displayed here rather than submit. You can see login has appeared here. Now, what about this value? What does this value do? So I want to write my name here, right? I'll write my name and I'll login. But what if I use this value? I write something in this value. If I write my name in this value, you can see that now while this site loads, my name will already be there. Do I want that to happen? No, right? Because I want to collect data from the users that visit my site. So I don't want this. So I leave this value field empty, but you should always add this field. Okay. Now I want this login button here on the new line. So how do we do that? We learned about line break tags, right? So we'll add a BR tag. Added a BR tag, but there's no space between both of them, right? So I'll add one more BR tag. Now you can see this proper spacing between the both of them. Okay. Now, what if you've seen many a times, there are multiple types of question that are asked. There's a question asked and you have to select an option. You have to check one option. You have to select one option. So what do we do? Now we are going to see a checkbox. So before that, I'll ask a question that what is your favorite color? What is favorite color? I want to ask that, right? I'll just type it out. After this submit button. Okay. What is your favorite color? I'm going to ask this, right? I'll just add a line break tag here. So what is your favorite color? And now I want to choose. Okay. Now again, I want to choose from various options. So the first thing I'll do is I'll create a checkbox. What is a checkbox? You'll just learn it right now. So input, then we add the attribute that is type. And inside this, we'll select the option called as checkbox. You can see checkbox. Now here I'll give it a name. Let's call it check. And I'll give it a value. Suppose first thing I want is red. Okay, I'll close this input tag and I'll write red outside this tag. I'll give a line break tag. Okay, now you can see that this red has appeared here and now I can select this. So this is what a checkbox basically is. You can tick on it, you can check on it, and it's a box, right? So it's a checkbox. Okay, and always remember that the value inside that you've written here should be similar to the text outside. Okay, so if I write, let's create one more. I'll just copy this, paste it here. I'll change the value. I'll call it blue. So this blue should be present here. It should also be blue. Okay. Now you can see I can select red and blue because if I have multiple favorite colors, right? And now I'll add one more. I'll call it black. Okay. Now you can see black has also been added. Okay, I'll just now that looks good. Okay, so now what a checkbox does is you can select multiple options. Okay, you cannot select one or two, you can select all the options if you want. This is what a checkbox does. Now, what if I want to answer a question that goes like this? What is the capital of India? So there's only one answer to this question, right? There can't be multiple answers. There's only one answer to this question. So we'll see how to select a single answer because checkbox selects all the answers, right? We want only one answer now. So again, we'll do input, then select type. And then instead of checkbox, this time we are going to add something called as radio. Okay, we'll add a radio in the type attribute. Then we'll give it a name. Let's call it radio. And in value, we'll give the correct answer. That's called Delhi. Delhi is the capital of India, right? Now we'll close off this input tag. And here also we'll write Delhi. We'll give a BR tag. Now, let's add one more option. Input. And in type, we'll again give it radio. Let's give it the name of radio. Because it's a radio button. And in this value, we'll write Mumbai. Okay. Again, here we'll write Mumbai. Give it a BR tag, one more BR tag. Now you can see the difference between checkbox and a radio button. In radio button, you can either select Mumbai or you can select Delhi. You cannot select both of them. If you select Delhi, you cannot select Mumbai. If you select Mumbai, you cannot select Delhi. But whereas in the same situation, if this checkbox, you can select both of them or you can select all of the three options. So you got the difference between checkbox and radio. Okay, these are the few type attributes, that type values that we are seeing. Now, where can you use checkbox and radios? If you want to take an input for MCQs from the user, both input types can be used. If you want multiple answers, you can use checkbox. If you want single answers, you can use radio. For checkbox, user can select as many values as they want. But for radio, it should only be one. Now, in this site that you saw, in the form was, I'll just show you once again. You can see this message part, right? And you can see that this message part is resizable, that you can give it how much ever size that you want. It depends on you, not it depends on the user, not on the one person that has created the site. Okay, you can resize this as long as you want. Okay, so now we are going to learn to how to add this. Let's go back to Atom. To use this, when do you use this? If you want a suggestion or a comment from a user, you use this. Okay, now how to do that? So to do that, we create a tag that is called text area. Okay, here's text area, and then we'll add one more closing tag, closing text area tag, right? And inside this you can put the message. Now you can see here that I can also resize this. Let me just show you. See, now I can resize this. I can enter my comments, my suggestions, anything here, numbers, alphabets, anything, special characters, anything I can enter here. So this is just a message box that I want. Okay, and I've just let it be empty. If I type something inside, you can see it will appear here. Okay, if you write anything here, it will appear here. Okay, so this was creating a text box. You can also give it a width and height. You can use attributes here. You can just give it length and whatnot. Okay, the next thing we're gonna see is a drop down menu. You guys may have seen drop down menu many of times. So we're just going to create a drop down menu right now. Okay, so we'll just create. So to create a drop down menu, you should use the select tag. You use a select tag and then again you close off the select tag. Okay, you can see before even writing anything, drop down menu has appeared here, but we have not given it any options, so it won't appear. Now the first thing that we want to do after creating the select option is we're going to input another tag that is called the option tag. Okay, and this option tag we're going to use an attribute. The attribute will be value. Okay, so we'll first, this is our first drop down option. Okay, so we'll give it a value of 01. Okay, we'll close it and here we'll write, please select your choice. We'll write this. Okay, and we'll close off this option tag. Let me just close it off. Now you can see that it has appeared here, please select your choice. Now I'll just create one more option. Let's create option value 02 and we'll say option 1. We'll call it option 1 and we'll close off this option tag. All right, we'll create one more. We'll create four options. Okay, so that you are familiar with how to use this. Paste. Now we'll just change the values. Here it will be 2, here it will be 3, and here it will be 4, it will be 3 here. We'll save this. Now you can see, please select your choice. You can see option 1, you can click on it. You can see option 2, you can click on it. You can see option 3 and you can click on it. Okay, and also there should be an attribute to this select tag. You should give it a name. We are going to create a drop down, so we'll give it a name of drop down. So this was about form basics. Okay, we'll just add a br tag right here. Okay, so now you can see that this is a complete basic HTML form using basic HTML elements. Okay, first we saw name. I'll enter my name here. Okay, then I'll select my favorite color. Now I have two favorite colors, that is black and blue. I'll select both of them. Then I know the capital of India, that is Delhi. Now I want a suggestion or I want a message, so I'll write hi there. Now I'll select your choice. I'll select my option, that is option one. And then I'll click on login. So now this data that I have entered, now you can see it has gone. So now this data has been submitted. Okay. This was creating a basic form using HTML. And if you guys want to open it up in your browser, just go ahead, open it up in a browser, see how it looks. Now you can see form basics, same thing in the browser. I'll enter my name. I'll select my favorite color, that is black and blue. I'll give it the capital of India, that is Delhi. You can see I cannot select Mumbai and Delhi. I have to only select one. I'll write my message, that is hi there. Okay, and I'll select my choice, that is option one. I'll log in. This data has been submitted. So that was it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next video.